Do you want more? I once heard it said that exactly 95% of people would like to get, be, do, or have more. And that the other 5% will probably lie about other things too. Most people want more. They want more holidays, more clothes, more shoes, more time, more money, more choice, a better home, a second home, a new car, to eat out more, or to spend more time with loved ones. Most people want more of something. But if you ask them what they're doing to learn how to get more, other than waiting and hoping, most people are doing very little, if anything at all. They just want a different outcome to what they currently have. So what about you? What are you doing to get a different outcome? In other words, what are you learning? What books are you reading or listening to? What shows are you watching? What podcasts are you listening to? What courses are you attending? Who do you associate with who has already achieved what it is that you want? You see, you earn what you currently earn based on what you currently know and do. So if you want to earn more, then you have to learn something that you don't currently know and then do something that you don't currently do in order to get a different result. I love the expression, nothing changes if nothing changes. But many people want and expect a change to happen in their life, but they expect the change to come from someone or something else. If you want something different, don't expect someone else to do it for you. It's not their responsibility. It's yours. It's all down to you. Many of the people who watch this are young, perhaps somewhere between 20 and 30 years young. Lucky you. And you're optimistic about your future, which is fantastic. You're optimistic about succeeding and becoming wealthier. But if I were to just dig a little bit deeper, you don't usually know how it's going to happen, but you're optimistic nonetheless that something will just happen. And I hope it does. But I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news, because the chances are that it won't. It won't happen unless you know what you want and start planning what you need to do, what you need to learn, and who you need to become in order to make your dream, whatever it is, a reality. The problem is that most people invest more time and energy planning their summer holiday than they do planning their life. But by the very act of planning your success, you're setting yourself up as being someone who is more likely to succeed. Some people will invest in assets like property or perhaps stocks and shares in the hope of a quick win and making some money. And some do, some don't. But what do you invest in yourself? Because you are your greatest asset. So what do you invest in the hope of growing you? Because if you have aspirations to get more from life, you need to be prepared to invest the time and the money, when necessary, to learn more and become more, and therefore get more as a result. So what skills don't you currently have? And more importantly, what are you going to do about it? Instead of just justifying why you can't put hair up or do extensions or get better at color cutting or whatever the skill is that you might be lacking in, why don't you enroll in an online class, buy a book or attend a live training, and then spend the time to practice until you master it? But please don't make the mistake that hairdressers often do by thinking that you only need to invest in learning better technical and creative skills, because as important as they are, that's only going to take you part of the way. It's every bit as important to invest the time into developing your own mindset, your people skills and relationship building and communication skills if you really want to succeed. So do you really want more? And have you got the necessary motivation and self-discipline to put in the time and effort to get more? Or is it all too hard? So what are some practical next steps? Well, can I suggest that you could brainstorm with your team these two questions? The first one is, As a team, what areas do we need to improve our skills in? And the second question is, as individuals, what areas do we underperform in? I have an online course, it's called Super Stylist. It's helped many stylists all over the world become more successful in the hair and beauty industry, and it can help you too. We launch it 3 times a year, and if you want to get on the wait list for the next launch, or are just curious about it and want to find out more, then visit growmysalonbusiness.com and register your interest to be notified when it's next open for enrollment. I'm sure you'll be glad that you did. And if you don't already follow us, then don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Facebook at Grow My Salon Business. Thanks for watching and have a great week.